Lauren Murdoch Smith, the Associate Beauty Editor at Grazia, and I'm here to take you backstage for the new beauty trends for Autumn Winter 11. I can't believe it's come around so quickly, but come and join me and I'm going to take you through all the new season looks. First of all, I'm going to jump in this amazing Marc Jacobs cab though, so why don't you come and join me? With Mac at Louise Gray, and I'm going to have a chat to James O'Reilly, who's working with Mac and heading up the makeup at Louise Gray. So James, could you just talk me a little bit through the inspiration for the look and this amazing colour that you're doing?
Yeah, I mean, the inspiration is always Louise's fashion, first and foremost. In this season, we decided to try and inject quite a lot of colour into the face, and I was quite inspired by a Japanese artist who just works solely in dots.
And the colours, are they reflected in Louise's collection?
Yeah, they're reflected in the collection and some of them clash a little as well. These are all chromographic pencils from MAC. Really highly pigmented, really easy to work with.
I'm going to grab Luke Hershison, who's heading up the hair team at Louise Gray, and he's going to talk us through the inspiration and the look for today.
We were looking at Kid and Play, House Party, Will Smith and Fresh Prince. It's very like a square kind of afro flat top, but kind of meets Margaret Thatcher baked in hairspray. We soaked the hair in L'Oreal Techniot Texture Tonic just to get a very dry texture to the hair. And after that, we backcombed up the whole top of the hair, smoothed it over, and then drew all the hair into a kind of tight ponytail just sits right on the bone of the back of the head, and then dented the front of the hair with a tong. It looks very, very square.
I'm in the back of the amazing Marc Jacobs cab on the way to House of Holland, and I'm really excited to go and see the hottest ticket in town, so come on, let's go and have a look backstage to see what they're up to beauty-wise. Stage at House of Holland, which is one of my favourite shows for the nails, hair and makeup, so let's find out a little bit about what's happening. I'm backstage at House of Holland and I'm just going to grab a couple of minutes with Lucia Pico, who's heading up the MAC team today. So can you tell me a little bit about the inspiration and the look you're doing?
So Henry's inspiration was tweed and granny with a modern twist, and it's actually, the collection's quite tailored and a bit more grown up. The skin is really groomed and really luminous with a strong lip as a focus of the look. The lips are defined with a lip liner, cherry, Ruby Woo lipstick, and then a mix of various colours, various lip mixes and a gloss.
As some of you probably already know, I'm a little bit obsessed with nails, so I'm really excited that I'm going to have a chat with Sophie Robson, who is London's dream nail queen. I'm here with Sophie Robson, who is doing the nails at House of Holland today. So what have you got in treat for us?
Well, we thought we'd go back to the new French style that we did at Louis Vuitton last year, but we've changed it a little bit because our collection is quite ladylike.
I've managed to grab a minute with Henry Holland.
I think the beauty element of the show is so important. I mean, it's, you know, everything goes to putting together the look and creating the woman that you're trying to portray for the people watching the show.
Last show of the day, which is Jonathan Saunders, and we're in this amazing futuristic venue in Paddington, which apparently is going to work really well with the collection. So let's find out a little bit about what beauty looks are going to be happening at the show. I'm now backstage at Jonathan Saunders and I'm going to go and chat to Paul Hanlon, who's going to chat to me about the hair today. Paul, can you talk me through the inspiration today for the look?
I think with the collection this time, there was a lot of reference to the 40s. Jonathan didn't want the the hair to look too lady in any way. He kept saying to me, I want it to feel very finished, very modern. So he loved the idea of this very kind of graphic, thick black headband in the hair, but we're making the texture much more finished. So we're making it super tight, very, very clean, and then super finished ponytails, a little bit of extension, making it very, very blunt on the end. And the profile, you get this really beautiful head shape with the band, just very simple, very pure.
So I'm here going to grab a moment with Lucia Peroni, who is heading up the MAC team at Jonathan Saunders, and she's working on Jordan Dunn. Lucia, can you just quickly tell me, hi, about the inspiration today and what you're doing for the look?
Okay, for Jonathan Saunders today, we're doing a 1930s greasy inspired eye. It's heavy on the socket, a really gorgeous kind of tobacco colour, tons and tons of mascara, nude lip, slightly sculpted cheeks, and then these super, super shiny glossy eyes.
So it's the end of the day. I'm just finishing at Jonathan Saunders, but it's been an amazing day for beauty. We've been to Louise Gray, where we had polka dot eyes. We had House of Holland, where it was an amazing raspberry red lip. And then we finished here at the futuristic Jonathan Saunders. So anyway, I'm going to head home now, and I'll see you bright and early tomorrow for day 2.